few seconds. Okay. Yes. So, yes, all of you. So, very good afternoon. Today, we are about, we have about to finish the half of the unit number one, because I'm going to take the just revised of how many topics we have covered and what are the things that we have already seen in the previous 5-6 lectures. Today, this is the seventh lecture which we are engaging with the advanced machine learning. So the unit number one is the feature engineering and the introduction. Okay. So guys, we have seen what do you mean by the machine learning, what are the outcomes which are related with the machine learning. Then also we have seen the applications. Then we have seen the how the artificial intelligence, deep learning, machine learning, data science, those are interrelated with each other, because artificial intelligence is the huge domain where inside that artificial intelligence, in one of the our slide, we have seen how AI and how that particular other parameters, like if you can only consider the AI, then under the AI, rather I will show you that diagram. I think with that slide I have not gone through. Just 1 minute, give me a minute. I will show you that. Yes, so that slide is in front of me. Yes, this is that slide. 1 minute, I will share that slide with you, all of you. Okay, so that is the slide which will be showing actually the yes, this is that slide. Okay, I hope this trends in machine learning, deep learning slide is visible to all of you. Okay, yes or no? Hello, whether this slide is visible?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So this is the artificial intelligence. Okay. Yeah. Under this artificial intelligence, machine learning is there, where various machine learning methodologies have been adopted. This is the neural net. That means neural networks concepts has been included here. Something deep learning is there, and along with neural networks. Okay. And along with this machine learning, in both of the these two or three areas inside this AI, the data science come into the picture. So these three, four parameters, these three, four methodologies or trends of machine learning are actually interrelated with each other. Then we have seen definition of the machine learning. Okay, what are the definition? What do you call as the feature in machine learning? How the feature has been extracted? For that purpose, we have also seen the three types of categories of machine learning, like supervised, unsupervised, and even we have gone through the reinforcement kind of learning. Then along with that, yesterday some techniques also. So under techniques, we have seen that machine learning approaches and supervised approach, unsupervised approach, and that is the thing. Then under the machine learning techniques, yesterday we have gone through the models, geometric model, probabilistic model, and logical models. Obviously, we will go into the details of this model and we will study the each and every algorithm which has been related with that. Okay, but today, before going for it, today I'm going also going to start with the feature engineering. But before to start with it, I think application part has been pending from the half of the unit. So I will take today the application, some of the examples of the application. These are the slides which contain the application of the image processing. Okay, so yesterday we have completed these models. Today we will move for the applications. please ping me in between if you don't get my voice, or if you have any problem, or if you wanted to ask any question. So kindly feel free to ask me. So under the application, face detection is one of the major applications. These five, whatever I have mentioned here, is the very common and very useful applications of the machine learning. The face detection, object detection, recognition. Here we will be using this computer vision. Okay, computer vision is also one of the what I can say, a huge area where image processing will come into the picture. So computer vision, image processing, object detection, face recognition, object recognition with the help of and machine learning is the major era of these machine learning algorithms. Then image segmentation. Segmentation means to segment the image. If time permits, I will take one or two example on the image segmentation. Then multimedia event detection. In multimedia event detection, we can see that, for example, if in a video, if some event is going to occur or in CCTV cameras, okay? CCTV is also a multimedia event detection where if some, what I can say, illegal activity occurs at the CCTV, like the theft or some CCTV footage, if you observe, then that will be also in the multimedia event detection. Then economical and commercial uses, okay? Economical website design, recommendation system, where stock market, share market, then even your all your websites like Twitter, Twitter website, then your Facebook website, WhatsApp data, whatever websites where huge millions of data is coming into the picture and will be get processed. So this is the economical and commercial uses of the machine learning. Okay, we will discuss one or two in detail. Machine learning is also used for understanding the prior domain, prior knowledge, and the goals. Where actually, if you remember, what is the domain of the machine learning? What knowledge, sort of knowledge you required, and what are your goals? Then data integration, selection, and cleaning, pre-processing, etc. These operations are getting performed on the that data. Then models will be get applied, results will be get interpreted, and the consolidated, or what I can say, a particular software has been get deployed with this particular discovered knowledge, and this has been getting complete. That means what? Now I will show you with the diagram over here. Okay, so this is something my prior knowledge I am having with respect to some application. Okay, so let us consider that this is the prior knowledge. Okay, prior knowledge means before starting with any of the application, I must able to know the prerequisites of that particular application. Okay, prerequisite means basic knowledge to start with that application. That is called as the prior knowledge. So with this prior knowledge, okay, I am having some goal. Let us say I have to define one expert system. Yesterday also we have discussed about the expert system, which will be working on the detection of the cancerous cell or not. So I have wanted to develop this expert system. So this is my goal, to develop the expert system. This is the prior knowledge I am having about the expert system. So first of all, I will understand my domain, whether I am having proper knowledge. Yes, I am having. Then collect the data. Okay, this is the data collection. This is the first step which I am applying over here. Second step is data collection, data integration, data selection, cleaning, pre-processing. That means data pre-processing activities will be getting performed based on this prior knowledge. Okay, when data has been get completely performed, okay, then some models has been get applied over here. Okay, that is called as the classifier. So here I am applying some classifier on this particular kind of data. Okay, here I have applied some classifier. These classifiers are also called as the learning model. So this is the step number 3. Now, after this completing process with the classifier, here I am interpreting the result. Okay, two results will be get interpreted. Either cancerous cells are present, yes, or cancerous cells are not present, no. Okay, so if the system is present, yes or no, based on that, some report will be get generated. Okay, here some report will be get generated based on this yes or based on this no. Okay, and this report will be get then deployed. Okay, this result will be get then deployed. Okay, so this is step number 3, interpreting result. This is step number 4, and deploying the results to the particular destination. This is step number 5. So when you repeat the step number 1 to 5, okay, when you are repeating and when you are going to do it from 1 2 3 4 5 and continuously, if this loop goes on and on and on, then this is called as the use of machine learning in practice. Okay, this is called as the use of machine learning in practice. You got it, everyone? How actually machine learning works to generate any expert system?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. In the same way, in image processing also the machine learning is used. Okay, for example, recognizing a face. Okay, for example, agar aapko bola jaye ki C++ mein ya C mein aap ek program likho where you have to recognize a face. So in that case, what will be the your first reaction? Okay, what will be your first reaction? We don't know what program to write because we don't know how our brain does it. Okay, jaise maine aapko, aapki koi friend hai, for example, x is the person, for x person y is her friend. Okay, y is her friend. So when x in front of x, if I am talking something about the y, then in the brain of x the image occurs of y. Okay, for example, whenever I am telling you that please imagine there is a apple which is red in color, having some droplets of water over it, and it is having a shiny nature, and it is sweet in texture. Okay, or it is sweet in taste. So you can imagine at the time whenever I was telling this, in front of your brain there was an image of a beautiful apple with red color into it. Even imagine a particular having a green leaf connected with that particular apple. Even you can imagine the green leaf. If I am telling you that imagine you are in an aeroplane and enjoying a rain outside the aeroplane, and aeroplane is in the sky and sky is full of the clouds. Even you can imagine these things, that you are sitting in a plane. Okay, so whatever scenario I am going to give you, based on that scenario your brain is actually processing something, because your brain knows how cloud looks, how black cloud looks, how plane looks, how you feel likewise, because somewhat time you might have experienced these things in your brain. So since your childhood, your brain is getting trained to recognize these things in front of your mind. So in the same way here, the computer has to recognize the same thing. So if I'm telling you that write down a program where your machine understands and you recognizes the apple. Okay, so in that case we don't know how our brain works. So even though it had a very good idea about how we do it, okay, so but this is little bit complicated process to do it. It's not difficult, but it's a complicated process. So for that purpose, what we have to do, we have to collect the lots of examples that specify the correct output for a given input. Even though if I will give you an example of the film industry here, whenever any director is there, in front of his director only the scenes has been get read out. So director is the person who is imagining something in his mind, and accordingly he is directing the film, and then that film will be get produced in front of the community. That means here also the brain works a lot to give the particular correct output to the customer. So here, before to write such program to recognize a face or something else, we need to do some kind of job over here. What is that job? The program produced by the learning algorithm may look different from a typical handwritten program. Correct? Because whatever your simulation software will do, that software program and your handwritten program both will be different. Even if somebody can imagine the things that let us say that which one is your favorite actor, then everyone can have the different imagination in your mind. So there is a person to person variation with the typical contents of the imagination. It means what? Whatever program you are doing, even if I am telling you that write down the program to generate the prime number, then at that time everyone will be using the different methodologies. Maybe 4 or 5 will use the for loop, maybe some of you will use while loop, and likewise still there is some differentiation in between the how you write the program. So there are millions of options available to write a program to recognize a face. So if we do it right, the program works for new cases as well as the one we train it on. Okay, so imagine this particular machine learning algorithm. Now here, this is the way how somebody writes the 0. This is the way how somebody writes the 1. कोई ऐसा वन लिखता है, कोई ये भी वन है, ये भी वन है, ये भी वन है. टू लिखने के कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स देखो. ओके, हर एक का हैंड राइटिंग अलग अलग है. दिस इज समथिंग व्हाट वी कॉल इट एज अ हैंड रिटन रिकॉग्निशन फॉर द डिजिट्स फ्रॉम 0 to 9. इफ यू ऑब्जर्व दिस, हर एक का 4 लिखने का स्टाइल अलग है, 5 लिखने का स्टाइल अलग है, हर एक का स्टाइल अलग है. यहाँ पे आप देखो 5 कैसे लिखा है, 6 कैसे लिखा है, 7 कैसे लिखा है. देन व्हाट हियर मशीन लर्निंग विल डू, इट विल प्रोबेबली कलेक्ट ऑल दो सैंपल्स विच इज हैविंग मैक्सिमम सिमिलैरिटी विथ ईच अदर. ओके, ये 3 छोड़ दो आप, ये देखो इनका 3, ये 3 देखो कैसा है, डिफरेंट है. ठीक है, तो दिस इज ऑल्सो 1, दिस इज ऑल्सो 1 एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो. अगर किसी को पता नहीं ये 1 है तो हम उसको L भी कह सकते हैं. ओके, सो दिस इज 7, 8, 9, लाइकवाइज हैंड रिटन रिकॉग्निशन. सो वी हैव टू राइट अ प्रोग्राम वेयर वी कैन रिकॉग्नाइज 0 to 9. ओके, इवन देर आर सम मोर एग्जाम्पल्स ऑफ द टास्क दैट बेस्ट सॉल्व यूजिंग द मशीन लर्निंग एल्गोरिथम्स, लाइक योर फेशियल एक्सप्रेशंस. ओके, facial expressions, handwritten or spoken words, medical image, motion sequences, okay, unusual credit sequences, credit card transactions, unusual patterns of the sensor readings of nuclear power plant, future stock, jahan pe commercial used hai yahan pe, okay, currency exchange rates, etc., etc. अनयूजुअल साउंड इन योर कार इंजिन. अभी आपने देखा होगा कि बहुत सारे कार अभी सेंसराइज्ड है, ऑटोमाइजेशन इज देयर इनसाइड द कार. अगर इफ कार में कुछ अनयूजुअल साउंड आ रही है, देन सेंसर्स इज गोइंग टू एक्चुअली गिव यू द अलार्म मैसेज दैट सम अनयूजुअल साउंड इज देयर. इवन अभी सेम थिंग वी कैन यूज विद द हेल्प ऑफ एन IoT. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, 2-3 दिन पहले एक ABP माजा पे एक न्यूज आई थी कि there will be a high tide at the Mumbai Marine Drive. So everyone be careful. So how they have identified that high tide is there? So inside the ocean, okay, some sensors has been get put up. That means some rods are there where we can place up some sensors. Actually, there is a high technology is required over there because sensors are mostly they should not be moist in nature or something else. But here, if the tide size goes beyond the frequency, then that network, virtual network, will generate some alarm. Like, for example, high tide is, let us say that, what is the height of the tide? So 65-70 feet, likewise, feet. So accordingly, if it goes particular frequency, then we can declare that there is a tsunami, chances of the tsunami. So likewise here there are different examples of the machine learning. Okay, this spam filtering fraud detection we have discussed in the first one or two lectures. Okay, so if you see some usual examples. Okay, now how you implement the machine learning. Okay, so for implementation, Python, Java, NetBeans, Weka, or any other open source software, but generally we use the Python, Java, and NetBeans. Okay, so these are the most common softwares which we will be using for the implementation. Okay, trends we will see later on. Yes, so half of the unit from machine learning is over now. Okay, half of the unit from machine learning is over now. Now any problem with respect to it? Any problem with respect to machine learning? Any problem, guys? Hello? No. You understood? How many people from computer are here? Actually, I found only 4 or 5 students are there from computer. Rest are from IT. Even IT also, I find around 10 people are not here in the class. Why people are not attending the classes? अभी तो ये सिर्फ पहला ही यूनिट है, हाफ ही यूनिट हुआ है. कुछ प्रॉब्लम है बच्चों? समझ में आ रहा है जो मैं बता रही हूँ? नो, देर इज नो क्लैश बिटवीन टू लेक्चर्स बिकॉज वी हैव एडजस्टेड द थिंग्स इन सच अ वे दैट देर विल बी नो क्लैश एंड वी हैव वेरीफाइड दैट देर इज अ नो क्लैश. Because regarding the computer students, I think Devika ma'am is the class teacher, no? Atharva? Okay. Okay. Okay, I will talk with Devika ma'am then. Let's see what will happen. Okay. So, yes. Now, we will be moving for the feature engineering. What is the feature engineering? In fact, in feature engineering also, we have seen how we are creating a training and test sets. That is also we have seen somewhat manner. Okay. But the rest of the features we have to study from the unit number 1. That is still pending from our side. Okay. So let us start with the feature engineering. Just a few seconds, I will share it. Feature engineering. Just 1 minute. Here I have saved it. Yes, now I will open it up, present it up. Just 1 minute, it is getting loaded. Yeah. आई थिंक मेरा नेट स्लो हो गया है, इसी की वजह से इट इज नॉट गेटिंग लोडेड प्रॉपरली, इट इज टेकिंग सम टाइम. गाइस एम आई ऑडिबल? ओके, बिकॉज एट माई एंड इट इज शोइंग इट इज नॉट रेस्पॉन्डिंग. Just excuse me if I'm not audible for a minute. I will again rejoin if any problem persists, because right now hi, I'm sorry, there is some net problem, net issue at my end. I hope I'm clear now, I'm audible now. Okay, guys, I'm audible, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, thank
yes,
you.
Ma'am.
Okay, now I will share it. I hope now it will not create any problem. Yes, is it visible now, teacher engineering?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, okay, thank God. Okay, see this feature engineering. This is the particular beautiful bridge. Actually, this bridge doesn't have any connection with our machine learning, but still I have kept it as it is. These are the slides which are available on the net. I like this bridge because it is having some features, beautiful features into it. So in the same way, how this bridge is beautiful, in the same way, your data, more data beats the clever algorithms, but better data beats the more data. Now, what is the meaning of this? It is little bit confusing, but if you see, if you are having n number of data, when machine learning will come into picture? When you have the huge amount of data with you, okay? And the algorithm has been get trained to work on and to pre-process on such more and more amount of data, okay? But instead of having the numerous data with you, if you have only related and better data, then it definitely beats the more concept of the more data. That means what? If I am having the n number of books with me, okay, if I am having the n number of books with me, but if those books are not related with the specific area of interest of my domain, then that whole library is useless for me. Okay, but if there are few books which are related with me, and even I'm also interested in reading that, then that few books cost a much for me as compared to the whole library. So that is the meaning. That means keep only the relevant data. Keep only the relevant data and discard all irrelevant things from your life. Even this principle is applicable to you in your daily life. Okay. For example, at your home also, if you keep the n number of things with you which are not of your use, then obviously those all things will become a garbage at our home. So time to time we must clean up the garbage, and time to time we must have the relevant things with you, and we must scrap out the irrelevant things. So this more data means the scrap data, the irrelevant data. Okay, so that is the thing. Okay, feature engineering, most creative aspect of the data science. Okay, this feature engineering, now up till now we have seen some part of the AI, some part of the machine learning. This feature engineering is the part of the data science. So this is the feature engineering is the most creative aspect. Okay, in that we will be having some what I can say, some templates, and we will treat it like other creative endeavor, like writing a comedy show. Okay, so there are different types of features. Okay, there are different types of features, and first important feature is the categorical data. What is the categorical data? How you manage it? What is the need of it? And what are the models which we are going to apply on the categorical data? For example, nearly always need some treatment. Okay, high cardinality can create very sparse data and difficult to impute the missing. Here, category means what? If I'm having some medical kind of data with me. Okay, medical kind means a medical related data. For example, a data of cancerous cells or a data of the persons who has been undergone with the COVID situation right now. So that is a kind of the categorical data where I can categorize the data from one domain to another domain. So that is called as the categorical feature. Okay. But if you create, for example, अभी हम कोविड का ही एग्जाम्पल ले ले, तो इन दैट केस वी विल बी क्रिएटिंग अ वेरी स्पार्स अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा. ओके, दैट मीन्स ह्यूज अमाउंट ऑफ डेटा हैज बीन गेट कलेक्टेड, और उसमें से हमें नॉइज रिमूव करना है या फिर न्यूसेंस रिमूव करना है. और हाउ वी आर मैनेजिंग विद द मिसिंग फीचर्स. ओके, हाउ वी आर मैनेजिंग विद द मिसिंग फीचर्स. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, जैसे जनगणना भी होती है, तो जनगणना में कैटेगरी डेटा रहता है, जैसे व्हाट इज द कैटेगरी ऑफ दोज पर्सन्स. फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ यू टेक द कैटेगरी ऑफ वर्किंग कल्चर, सो हाउ मेनी आर द क्लास वन, क्लास टू, क्लास थ्री, लाइक दिस इज द वन कैटेगरी. और हाउ मेनी ऑफ द पर्सन्स, और व्हाट इज द नंबर ऑफ पर्सन्स हु आर इन्वॉल्व फ्रॉम द कातरस साइड, दैट इज द फर्स्ट, हु आर इन्वॉल्व फ्रॉम द पिंपरी चिंचवड साइड, that is the category two. Likewise, area wise also we can have things. So in that case, if the data is in a categorical fashion, then we must able to manage the missing features from the categorical features. Okay, so here we will be using the one hot encoding. Now here, this is the slide which will be giving only some of the encoding features and decoding features. Okay, तो इतना डिटेल में नहीं देखेंगे हम इसको. ओके, वन मिनट, आई विल जस्ट चेक आउट. देर आर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट मेथड्स आर देयर. माय पर्टिकुलर स्लाइड इज आई थिंक नो. ओके ओके, आई थिंक I have opened up some new slide over here. Never mind. But the thing which I wanted to tell you is missing here. Chalo, no issues. Just give me 1 minute, huh? एक्चुअली मशीन लर्निंग मैंने लास्ट टू लास्ट सेमेस्टर पढ़ाया था, okay, and most of the contents of machine learning are on my college PC. Okay, so here I am finding out some contents, then here I am doing it, validating it at my side, and then I am presenting it in front of you. Because of that might be some miscommunication from my end is there, but theek hai. Theek hai. Now we will do one thing. Okay, instead of continuing with these slides, okay, instead of continuing with this slide, I will stop it presenting those slides, because those slides are actually a little bit irrelevant for you. Okay, right now it is not useful, but those will be useful for you in your next upcoming features. So theek hai, I will show you some another things. Okay, just give me a minute. मैं आपको एक अभी छोटा सा ये दिखा रही हूँ यहाँ पे, एक छोटा सा विंडो दिखा रही हूँ, वहां पे यू कैन सी, यस ये देखिए, फ्यूचर इंजीनियरिंग में हाउ यू आर क्रिएटिंग अ ट्रेनिंग एंड टेस्ट सेट्स. ओके, हाउ यू आर क्रिएटिंग एंड ट्रेनिंग अ टेस्ट सेट्स. दिस इज योर ओरिजिनल डेटा सेट. फ्रॉम योर ओरिजिनल डेटा सेट यू विल बी अप्लाइंग सम रैंडम शफलिंग एंड यू विल बी यूजिंग दिस ट्रेनिंग सेट एंड टेस्टिंग सेट. एक्चुअली कल हम लोगों ने कुछ प्रैक्टिकल किए हैं विद द कॉम स्टूडेंट्स ऑल्सो, वेयर इन दिस अपकमिंग नेक्स्ट 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 टर्न, इन अपकमिंग नेक्स्ट टर्न वी विल बी एक्चुअली डूइंग दिस डेटा सेट्स विद द ट्रेनिंग एंड टेस्टिंग. ओके, सो दिस इज यूज्ड टू जनरेट द एग्जैक्ट आउटपुट. ठीक है, ये देखिए यहाँ पे ये ट्रेन टेस्ट स्प्लिट फंक्शन यहाँ पे यूज कर रहे हैं हम लोग भी. ये स्काई किट लर्न वाला ही पैकेज हम लोग यूज करने वाले. दिस इज स्काई किट लर्न. दिस पैकेज एक्चुअली इज यूज्ड इन द पाइथन प्रोग्रामिंग. ओके, एंड हियर फ्रॉम स्काई किट लर्न मॉडल वी कैन इम्पोर्ट द सिलेक्शन एंड देन वी कैन स्प्लिट द गिवन डेटा सेट. ओके ओके, I can import the selection and here I can able to split it. So this X train, X test, Y train, Y test. Okay, some of the data from X and Y will be for training and some of the data from X and Y will be for the testing. So train the test split X, Y, test size is equal to 0.25. That means 25% of data I am giving for the testing and remaining I am giving for the training. So here I am only writing for testing, that means remaining I am giving for the testing. Okay, so this is how we are actually managing with the things. Okay, now yahan pe aap dekho managing with the categorical data. Okay, yahan pe how you are managing it with the help of a numpy. Okay, managing means what? Whatever is the missing values are there in the categorical kind of data, that missing values we can add it or we can import it or we can resize it using this NumPy methodology. So all these NumPy, SkyScape, whatever the packages are available, because Python is full of the inbuilt libraries which we can use for the data training and testing purpose. So it's a very interesting kind of library. Even I will be showing you a live practical demo for this, the training and testing using NumPy, using SkyKit and rest of the things. Okay, so here now instead of discussing this program over here, I will be just skipping it out, because right now we have not completed the categorical data. So that is why I'm not going into the detail of the categorical data classification model. So that we will go for the next lecture. Okay, now any problem from today's lecture, guys? In the next lecture, we will be covering categorical data मैनेजिंग द मिसिंग फीचर्स, डेटा स्केलिंग एंड नॉर्मलाइजेशन, फीचर सिलेक्शन, फिल्टरिंग एंड पीसीए. एक बार हमारा पीसीए हो गया देन योर फर्स्ट यूनिट विल गेट ओवर. ओके, बिकॉज राइट नाउ वी आर एट द सिक्स्थ लेक्चर. सो फॉर फर्स्ट यूनिट ओनली 8 लेक्चर्स आर प्लान. सो इन नेक्स्ट अपकमिंग 2 लेक्चर्स एक्चुअली दिस पोर्शन विल बी गेट कवर अप. सो नो इश्यूज, वी विल एबल टू कम्प्लीट द यूनिट नंबर 1 टिल नेक्स्ट वीक. ओके, नेक्स्ट वीक में हमारा हो जाएगा यूनिट नंबर 1. एंड देन वी विल बी हैविंग अ क्विज टाइप ऑफ असाइनमेंट्स. उसमें 6 एमसीक्यू क्वेश्चंस रहेंगे और 4 आपके क्वेश्चंस रहेंगे जो शॉर्ट आंसर्स रहेंगे. ठीक है, समझ में आ गया. फर्स्ट जो आपका सीई रहेगा, फर्स्ट सीई जो रहेगा उसमें आपको 10 मार्क्स का सीई रहेगा. उस 10 मार्क्स के सीई में मैं चैट बॉक्स में लिख रही हूँ. ओके, तो सिक्स क्वेश्चंस विल बी एमसीक्यू बेस्ड क्वेश्चंस. ओके, प्लस 4 क्वेश्चंस विल बी शॉर्ट आंसर क्वेश्चन. तो जैसे 6 यूनिट्स है, सो बेस्ड ऑन दिस 6 यूनिट्स 6 सीई विल बी गेट परफॉर्म. एंड सेवंथ विल बी द मिनी प्रोजेक्ट. ओके, सेवंथ विल बी द मिनी प्रोजेक्ट. सो मिनी प्रोजेक्ट कैरीज टोटल 100 मार्क्स. ओके, मिनी प्रोजेक्ट विल बी कैरिंग टोटल 100 मार्क्स, वेयर इन दैट मिनी प्रोजेक्ट वी विल बी क्रिएटिंग अवर डेटा सेट. ओके, वी विल बी प्री प्रोसेसिंग इट. आफ्टर प्री प्रोसेसिंग वी विल बी अप्लाइंग अवर लर्निंग मॉडल. आफ्टर अप्लाइंग द लर्निंग मॉडल देन वॉट वी विल डू, वी विल हैव अवर प्रेडिक्शन. आफ्टर द प्रेडिक्शन वी विल सी वेदर वी हैव गॉट द 100% करेक्ट एक्यूरेसी इन गेटिंग द रिजल्ट और नॉट. ठीक है, एंड देन we will deploy that model on the cloud. Okay, and from cloud that data should be accessible at any moment of time. So this is your mini project under the machine learning. Okay, so that's the thing. So 6C ke liye aapko 60 marks. Okay, so total 160 marks ho jate hai, yani 100 marks ka mini project. 60 मार्क्स फॉर योर सीई एंड योर प्रैक्टिकल जो भी रहेंगे. ठीक है, हम लोग जो भी प्रैक्टिकल परफॉर्म कर रहे हैं तो 2 आवर्स प्रैक्टिकल अगर आप देखोगे तो प्रैक्टिकल के भी मार्क्स आउट ऑफ 100 है. तो टोटल मार्क्स हो गए आपके एएमएल के लिए
260.
एंड देन वी विल दैट 60 मार्क्स विल बी कट डाउन, दैट मीन्स स्केल डाउन टू 100. ठीक है, ओके एवरीवन. सो फॉर्मेटिव असेसमेंट, समेटिव असेसमेंट, उन सब के मार्क्स हम लोग नोट डाउन करने वाले हैं. ओके, सो एनी प्रॉब्लम आज के लेक्चर में, समझ में आया? ओके, आपको कुछ पूछना है मुझे? You have, if you have anything in your mind, you can ask me. Nothing? Mark your attendance in the chat box. आपको नाम लिखना है, रोल नंबर लिखना है, आपका डिपार्टमेंट लिखना है. And I'm sorry for the today's 5 minutes break because it's a internet issue at my side. The network was very low because of that. I usually don't have the network problems, but today I have got it. So kindly excuse me for that. Okay. Thank you. ओके।